say, I have no idea. Who is it?
It's Mr. Ed.
Mr. Ed? He's been here every day this week. What's his problem today?
It's his preposition.
His prepositions? It could be another case of Chinglish. We better go have a look. Good morning, Mr. Ed. How are you today?
I am fine, but I had to wait you almost 25 minutes.
Did you hear that, Doctor? He said I had to wait you.
That's right. That's right. He said I had to wait you. He left out the preposition, Miss Judy. He left out the preposition for. He had to wait for 25 minutes. This is a serious case of Chinglish. Lots of people in Hong Kong leave out a preposition after the word wait. Mr. Ed, show me your face. Say this. Repeat after me. I had to wait for 25 minutes.
I had to wait for over 25 minutes.
How did he do, Nurse Judy?
Not bad.
What do you think we should do with this patient? He's been here every day this week.
We need to practice more.
You hear that, Mr. Ed? You won't learn English lying in bed sleeping. You need to practice your English. Repeat after me again. I had to wait for almost 25 minutes.
I have to wait for almost 25 minutes.
That's right. There are many prepositions you can use after the word wait. You can say, wait until I get there. I had to wait with my sister. But you have to put something after the word wait instead of wait you, wait me. Don't forget that, will you?
No.
Okay, Nurse Judy, I'm going back to the office now. You let me know how he does. If he doesn't practice,